Please sit down.
Good morning.
So, Mr. Srivastava, why do you wish to join the civil service?
So, I think that the civil services is a very exciting opportunity to be of use to the nation, and it is a way to use my education, 23 years of education, in a more impactful way.
Foreign service is your first choice?
Yes, sir.
Right. And if you, we all wish that you will get foreign service. If you didn't get it,
yes,
which would be your next choice?
So the Indian administrative service.
Right.
So all the services excite me for different reasons, which I have opted for. But the Indian administrative service provides a way to function in very diverse departments. One can work in health, education, and so on, and learn a lot. And the leadership opportunity in the early 10 years or so of one's career, where one is managing an entire district, is something that one can really learn and grow.
It's a challenge.
Yes, sir. Yes.
So is this your first attempt?
Sir, this is my second attempt,
uh-huh.
But it's my first interview.
First interview.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Rajin.
Mr. Srivastava, you mentioned in your extracurricular activities fitness.
Yes,
what exactly do you mean by that?
So, for me,
yeah,
fitness
what
is a pursuit for making my body healthier.
Okay.
And it's a lifestyle that I live. So, for me, it's the small things that I can do to live in a healthier way.
I mean, do you jog or do you do yoga?
Yes, sir.
Or?
I ensure that I get at least 30 minutes of cardio every day.
Okay.
So it's at least walking or jogging. So at least that.
But do you go to a gym?
Yes,
or do you
sir.
Do?
I ensure that I get at least 4 gym workouts a week.
Okay.
I can't manage more than that.
Good.
But
good.
Just 4 times a week.
So you think that fitness helps in general well-being?
Sir, it helps me feel
yeah,
more
does.
Confident.
Of course it does. It's
and, I always feel more alert and better.
Yeah, that's true. Very good.
Okay.
Now, you know this issue of the Sabarimala temple issue.
Yes, sir.
This is a huge controversy which is going on in the matter now rests with the Supreme Court.
Yes, sir.
What was the controversy all about? Very briefly.
Yes, sir. The Sabarimala temple in Kerala is an Ayyappa temple, and the devotees of the Ayyappa temple believe that the Ayyappa deity is a celibate god, and therefore it has been an age-old custom to not allow women of menstruating age to enter the temple.
So when the Supreme Court allowed it, what happened?
So when the Supreme Court allowed it, the Kerala state government said that they will follow the Supreme Court orders and facilitate the entry of women of all ages into the temple premises, and they did so by providing police protection and other protection that was necessary.
So my question
but
was that why is the Supreme Court reviewing its own judgment? It's doing that, isn't it?
Yes, sir.
How?
So the
oh,
Supreme
why?
Court is empowered under the Constitution to review its own judgment.
Okay.
But the matter is a little controversial because the argument is that the Supreme Court should not decide what are the essential practices of religion. It should be for the devotees and the people
yes.
who are following that.
So basically the Supreme Court has constituted what they call a 7-member bench.
Yes, sir.
So it will not only look into this issue of Sabarimala, it's also going to look into the requirement of Muslim women.
Yes, sir.
Their entry into mosques.
Yes, sir.
Why has that, how has it been clubbed with this?
So they are similar issues.
So has anybody raised this issue in the Supreme Court? The Muslim women, have they raised this issue or what?
Sir, I'm not exactly aware of those details.
Good. Okay. Now, have you been following what's happening in the Northeast?
With respect to the Citizenship Amendment Act?
Not that, but okay.
With the
Bodo Accord.
Yes.
Who are the Bodos and what is this accord all about?
Yes, sir. So the Bodos are a community of people that live to the north of the Brahmaputra River, mainly in Assam.
Yeah.
And there is an insecurity amongst them that outsiders have encroached upon their
Yeah, they are tribals basically.
Yes, sir.
Yeah.
And
so what was their demand? up till now?
Yes, sir. So, the movement has been ongoing. There have been demands from different sections of the border mm-hmm. population. Some have demanded greater autonomy within the framework yeah. of the Assam state. Some have demanded statehood in the form of borderland. Some have taken secessionist tendencies, and there is a violent streak as well. So the border accord was signed between the central government and the state government of Assam, along with the representatives of the border.
All the various factions of the, particularly the NDFP.
Yes, sir.
Which was the most violent group.
Yes, sir.
So have they decided to give up the demand for statehood now?
Sir, I'm not exactly aware if they've given up the demand.
That is the basic issue, that through this accord, all the groups which were involved have given up the demand for statehood.
Yes, sir.
And the, in return, the center has promised them certain packages,
yes,
economic development,
yes,
their language to be looked after and all that.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Now, have you heard of the scheme called Udaan? What was the scheme?
It is about extending air travel facilities to people of all economic
So has it been successful?
Sir, I'm not that aware on the progress of the scheme.
Right. Thank
I'm
you.
Sorry, sir.
Thank you.
Prithima, you are aware the United States President is visiting India in the last week of February.
Yes, sir.
When our Prime Minister and the US President sit across the table, what do you think should be on the table? What are the issues, important issues?
Yes, sir. So there are many priorities that our Prime Minister should be discussing with the US President. First, the issue of the H-1B visa for working abroad to facilitate the NRI community in the US. The second would be the issue of cross-border terrorism from Pakistan.
Sure.
And the enhanced risks to Indian security in the event of a US withdrawal from Afghanistan, which is being talked about. Certain developmental initiatives that can be taken for cooperation. Certain defense cooperation initiatives. We already have a 2+2 framework, the foreign and defense ministries there. Something about the Quad framework as well. So with the US, Japan, and Australia to involve greater cooperation. That is all that is
You left out the most important one, trade.
Sorry.
Okay, never mind. Now, you have heard about the CAA, Citizenship Amendment Act, and the NRC.
Yes, sir.
The process has been gone through in Assam.
Yes, sir.
Now, the Assamese people are opposing CAA on grounds which are different from the rest of the country.
Yes, sir.
What is the core of their opposition to CAA?
So the people of Assam feel an insecurity due to the overwhelming number of outsiders or migrant population in Assam. And even in the Assam Accord, the NRC process was initiated from there to identify the illegal immigrants. Now, the opposition to the Citizenship Amendment Act comes from the possibility that some of these illegal immigrants might be able to acquire Indian citizenship and become voting citizens. And within Assam, they would then constitute a constituency politically.
You are leaving out a very specific point with regard to dates.
Yes, sir. Within the framework of the Assam Accord, the illegal migrants before the year of 1971 will be awarded citizenship. In the Citizenship Amendment Act, the cutoff date is 2014.
Okay. So that's the most important point. Anyway,
yes.
Now the Government of India has decided to sell off the Air India.
Yes, sir.
It had made an attempt last year,
yes,
which
sir.
Failed. There were no takers. Why do you think we should have optimism this time around that the Government of India's bid might succeed?
Sir, because this time the offer that is proposed by the Government of India involves 100% devolution of
not
its stake.
Not almost 100%.
Yes, sir. 100% divestment of its stake along with management control. And they are also divesting 50% of its subsidiary share,
yeah,
in AISATS, which is the catering service, if I'm not mistaken.
Yes.
So it is a more attractive.
There is another sweetener. What is that in the package?
Sir, they are also selling off the 100% share in the Air India Express, which is a low-cost carrier with the Air India.
The date has been hived off.
Right, sir.
Date. It's hived off to 23,000 plus crores from earlier,
yes,
almost
sir.
50.
Yes, sir. The special SPV has been created for that.
The Indian constitution has been subjected to influences from different constitutions of the world.
Yes, sir.
Can you give 2-3 specific examples?
Yes, sir. The chapter on fundamental rights has been influenced by the Bill of Rights that is there in the US Constitution.
Right.
The element of justice, social, economic, political, is inspired from the ideals of the Russian Revolution.
What about the preamble? So much is being talked about everywhere. People are reading the preamble to the Constitution.
So the concept of liberty, equality, fraternity,
yeah,
inspired by the French Revolution. The concept of fundamental duties comes from the Japanese Constitution. So that's all that I
Thank
want
you.
To recall
Thank
at this
you.
Point.
That's all.
Ridhima, you've written that you were a joint head of public relations team.
Yes, ma'am.
So what were the abilities required to handle this job?
Yes, ma'am. A joint head for the public relations team would require the ability to write in a succinct manner,
mm-hmm,
to be able to release press inputs from the College Fest's perspective. Would require leadership skills to lead.
What are leadership skills?
Ma'am, in my role, I was asked to identify identify what roles would be allocated to which members in my team, depending on their abilities.
Decision making was one of the major qualities?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay.
Yes,
what
ma'am.
Else?
So, decisions regarding the press passes and which press members are to be sent.
Think these qualities would help you as an administrator? Leadership qualities?
Yes, ma'am, they would. Leadership qualities means that one would be comfortable with making decisions,
mm-hmm,
handling situations that might be unprecedented, being able to motivate one's team. So it will be very useful. As an
Now, you've also written blogging as your extracurricular,
yes,
activity. So what was the issue that you last wrote on?
Ma'am, I last actually wrote a poem.
Okay. You
and
remember it? Can you say a few lines?
Yes, ma'am, I remember a few lines.
Okay.
Often.
Title?
Ma'am, it is called Chronicles of Darkness.
Okay, just two lines.
Yes, ma'am. Then I'll quote the best two lines,
okay,
that I remember. The idea of freedom I do adore, but within the eagerness to explore, there lies a desire to belong, and the universe hums its own song.
All right.
Yes, ma'am.
Now, do you think we deserve freedom of speech in our country?
Ma'am, freedom of speech is something that the founding fathers of this nation have fought for
mm-hmm,
almost 200 years. So, it is a right to be safeguarded. However, there are reasonable restrictions on this right that
mm-hmm,
have been placed under Article 19. And that have been implemented by the administration in cases where it has led to violence or incident.
Do you think we are going overboard as far as sedition is concerned?
Ma'am, there have been demands to scrap the Sedition Act altogether because it's not seen in many of the older democracies of the world. However, India faces certain peculiar security challenges, ma'am, with the two very hostile neighbors. We have issues of cross-border terrorism. We have.
But do you think just criticizing the government of the day actually means sedition? Or they such people should be hauled under this clause?
Ma'am, criticizing the government of the day is a right that is provided under the Constitution.
Okay, so you've given me an answer. Yes. Now, next question. Do you think social media should be regulated?
Ma'am, social media provides a lot of freedom to express whatever one wants to without the censorship of even an editor in a newspaper like there used to be. While that has democratized the information process in general, there have been instances where social media has been involved in aggravating violence in certain pockets.
So it should be regulated to some extent.
Yes, ma'am, and there are instances of child pornography, there are instances.
Okay, I get your answer.
Yes, ma'am.
Last question related to your state. You're from Punjab.
Yes, ma'am.
There's a very prevalent drug problem.
Yes, ma'am.
They say every household has at least one person who's involved with drugs.
Yes, ma'am.
What can we do to overcome this problem?
Yes, ma'am. The first thing that we can do to overcome this is to identify the pockets of Punjab where the drug problem is most prominent and identify the peddlers.
Okay. Identification next?
Yes, ma'am. Identifying the peddlers and cracking down on the drug mafia. And the government has already strengthened the Narcotics, Drugs and Psychotropic Substances Act to add a death penalty in case someone is caught with commercial quantities. The third would be proactive identification of people who have succumbed to substance abuse. And
do we have any rehabilitation programs in Punjab?
Yes, ma'am. There are drug rehabilitation homes all around Punjab, and the city that I come from, Chandigarh, is the capital. There's a drug de-addiction center in my sector, within 5 kilometers as well.
How effective are they?
Ma'am, I think that they are effective if the person who has been sent there and their family is determined to get rid of it. Yes, thank you.
Hello, Ritima.
Hello, sir.
You got the foreign service as your first choice.
Yes, sir.
Any particular reason for that?
So while I was excited by the prospect of just being in the public service, and my rank will eventually decide where I end up, the foreign service is my first preference because I think it's a unique opportunity to take India's priorities to the world and to represent my country abroad. Moreover, I think it is an opportunity to become multilingual and to learn from different cultures and to understand the best practices in the world so that we can bring them back to our country and influence our country's development.
Excellent.
Yes, sir.
Which country poses the biggest security threat to India?
So, while Pakistan has remained an irritant for a long time, I think that the country that poses the biggest security threat is China at this point. Because China is creating a string of pearls around India by making proactive relationships with India's neighborhood in order to isolate India's influence. China is also collaborating with Pakistan on the CPEC corridor, which affects India's sovereignty, and it has shown no concerns of no intention of rectifying that. And China is also supporting Pakistan on Kashmir. So the step that we've taken by revoking Article 370 and integrating Jammu and Kashmir has been challenged multiple times by China and the UNSC. China has been blocking us on security concerns in the UNSC many times. especially with the designation.
Good, good, good.
Yes, sir.
Good answer. What has been the biggest internal security threat to India, the country? What has been the biggest security threat to the country in the last 20, 30 years?
Sir, I'll take a minute to think about it.
Yeah, sure, sure. By this, I don't mean this threat coming from inside.
Yes, sir.
I don't mean that.
Yes,
I mean threat coming from outside also.
Yes, sir.
So, you know, you can see, you can consider in your mind all these things and tell me which is the biggest security threat that India has faced in the last 20, 30 years.
So, in the last 20, 30 years, India has suffered from terrorism. Which has affected the common people, and it has affected the world's perception of India, especially whenever attacks like 26/11 happened. There is always a conversation about whether India is safe to be in, to do business with. The people of the country live in constant
fear. Okay. So which part of India has been affected most?
By terror attacks, sir?
Terrorism, yes.
Yes, sir. Sir, the state that I come from, Punjab, has certainly had a homegrown militancy in the 1980s.
Kashmir
also has a militancy, sir, but I find it difficult to compare between different pockets of India at that point.
Okay. What has been the single biggest element in the relationship between China and Pakistan?
Yes, sir.
In your view?
So I think that their strategic interests converge.
No, that's okay.
Yes, sir.
What has China done to Pakistan?
Yes, sir.
To make it powerful?
Sir, China has invested heavily in Pakistan with respect to the Gwadar Port and the CPEC in general. And China is definitely holding up Pakistan's economy, which is dwindling very quickly.
Okay.
So economically, China is taking care of Pakistan. And it's also supporting Pakistan's political priorities vis-a-vis India on global platforms. So,
how has Pakistan acquired its nuclear capability?
Sir, I'm not sure about the exact story. But I am aware that Pakistan acquired its nuclear capabilities by bits and pieces. They had an ambassador abroad.
Hmm.
And I'm sorry, sir. I can't remember the exact story.
Okay. Never mind.
Yes, sir.
So what is the biggest international story today? The biggest headlined story all over the world today?
So, the headline of today's newspaper was that India was evacuating its citizens from China where there is a outbreak of the coronavirus.
Yes.
Good.
Now, where are these, most of these students located?
Sir,
There is a particular city in China.
So Wuhan is the place,
yes,
where the outbreak is,
yes,
but I don't remember the exact
place.
Where
Wuhan is the exact place.
Yes, sir.
Okay.
Sorry, sir.
Good. Now, what is India's position on the Israeli-Palestinian issue?
Yes, sir. India's position is that there should be a two-state solution,
mm,
and India stands with the Palestinians,
mm,
in their right to self-determination,
okay,
and their right to autonomy.
Good.
But there has also been a de-hyphenation between,
mm,
Israel and Palestine,
yes,
in India's perspective,
yes,
especially in the last few years or so, after Kargil.
Yes.
And so India has...
So do you think that was the right to de-hyphenate? It was correct? Do you think it was a
correct? Yes, sir, it serves India's priorities.
Okay.
Because India can cooperate so much with Israel.
Okay.
Yes.
Okay. Are you aware of a very high profile assassination carried out by the United States a couple of weeks ago?
Yes, sir.
Who was?
Sir, he was a top military officer from Iran.
What was his name?
General Soleimani, if I'm not mistaken.
Yes. Yes. Okay. And final question to you.
Yes, sir.
That this, you know, the CAA and NRC issue.
Yes, sir.
The European Union Parliament.
Yes, sir.
They were supposed to discuss it and take a vote just
yes,
now.
Sir.
But they have postponed it.
Yes, sir.
Why?
So I'm not sure why they postponed it.
Never mind. Yes, it was postponed because our Prime Minister was having a bilateral dialogue with the EU.
Yes.
And they did not want it to happen before that.
Yes, sir.
To spoil the whole atmosphere.
Yes.
Okay. Thank you.
Now you've done something in electrical engineering.
Right? So I've studied electronics and electrical,
electrical
communication.
Also?
So we had some courses.
I see.
Yes.
Are you aware how much is our installed power generation capacity in India?
Sir, I can't recall the exact figure.
What are the targets for renewable energy which the Modi government has set?
So the target is to increase the renewable energy mix to 40% by 2022.
But they have also said 175 gigawatts, you know.
Yes, sir.
By which date? Which year?
So I think it's 2022, but I
22, correct. You are absolutely right. Out of which, how much is solar?
So 100 gigawatts is solar.
Very good.
40 is rooftop.
How much we have reached till now? Renewables. Now, what is India's electronic vehicle policy?
Yes. So, India is proactively promoting the sale of electronic vehicles by improving the availability of charging stations across...
No, they have set a date by which...
Right.
So they have a policy,
yes, sir.
Electronic vehicles policy.
Mm-hmm.
No, electric vehicles,
yes, sir.
Not electric. Now, climate change.
Yes, sir.
Would you consider that climate change is the most serious threat to humanity today? Would you say that? Or would you like to say that any other threat is more serious than this?
Sir, I will say that climate change is certainly impending doom for humanity today, if we don't kill each other through nuclear weapons.
Now, since you are interested in foreign,
yes,
service, and also you must be well informed reading newspapers.
Yes, sir.
Can you cite one or two important reports which came out in November, December on the dire state of climate change? And what do they say, those reports?
Yes, sir. So the Intergovernmental Panel on Climate Change, the IPCC report came out, which said that...
most recent reports.
So the emissions gap report by the UNEP has come out. And that has said that, that even if all countries were to meet their
priorities...
There
is one United Nations Environment Programme report.
Yes, sir.
Which came out in November. Do you have any idea what it said? Briefly, one or two sentences.
I remember the UNEP's emission gap report came out.
Okay. Then there was a report which was published by a group of scientists.
Yes, sir.
Led by a scientist called Timothy Lenton.
Yes, sir.
He's a scientist, climate scientist at the University of Exeter.
Yes, sir.
It also came out. Would you have any idea about this report which was published in a journal called Nature?
So the report is coming to me, but I'm not able to recall the contents exactly.
It said we are heading towards a tipping point.
Yes.
That is a point of no return,
yes,
in this. Mm-hmm. So these are very important reports. What was the Westphalian Treaty in foreign affairs?
So
very famous treaty.
Yes, sir, it sounds
good. It ended the 30-year war and then established a certain principle in international relations. No idea. Now, you were asked a question on Air India's disinvestment.
Yes, sir.
What is the target of disinvestment for the current year, government has said? And how much it has achieved?
Sir, I'm not
aware. No idea. Okay, never mind. India decided not to join the REC. RECP.
Yes, sir.
What is RECP?
Sir,
on
the
full form?
Full form is Regional Comprehensive Economic Partnership. It is a trade agreement with the Asian countries and
how many countries are negotiating to get into it? To form this?
Sir, 16 countries.
16, very good.
So the 10 Asian countries.
And ASEAN.
ASEAN. And India.
Why did India refuse?
Sir, there were many contentious issues. One was an apprehension that Chinese goods would flood the Indian market. And China is in fact the only country that India doesn't have an FTA with in this group or is not in a negotiation with. So we have an FTA with ASEAN and most other countries, but we're negotiating with them.
Do we have an adverse trade balance with China?
Yes, sir. There is a huge trade imbalance in favor of China.
About how much?
$55 billion,
yeah.
Sir, if I'm not
mistaken. And do we have an adverse trade balance with America?
Sir, the trade balance is in favor of India.
You're okay.
Yes, sir.
Now, I'm asking last question.
Yes, sir.
Supreme Court has given a very major recommendation on the question of defections. You know the defection law?
Yes, sir.
Under which schedule in the constitution does it fall?
So the 10th schedule.
10th schedule, very good. But this law has not been very effective.
Yes, sir.
So what has the Supreme Court said? The core recommendation the Supreme Court has given.
So the Supreme Court has...
came out only last week.
Yes, sir. The Supreme Court has recommended curtailing the speaker's powers in the absence of the speaker's political neutrality.
In what way it will, it says, it hasn't said that you curtail the speaker's power, but it will be curtailed in effect. What has it suggested or recommended to the government?
So they've recommended that a panel should be established, an independent.
Permanent commission.
Yes.
Headed by a Supreme Court retired judge or a Chief Justice of High Court.
Yes, sir.
Because, why?
So
what is the concern which Supreme Court is expressing?
Sir, there were apprehensions about politically motivated decisions on the defections
on the
that
part
have,
of the speaker.
Yes, especially in hung assemblies.
Speakers have not been fair,
yes,
and
sir,
impartial. Therefore, Supreme Court has made this statement.
Yes,
they all, because they are elected from the ruling party,
yes,
and they don't give up their political affiliation.
Yes.
That is why. All right, good. We close the interview here. Now, we like to give you a little feedback.
Yes, sir. So may I note it down?
Yeah, sure, you can. You've done well, by and large, you've done well. Your parents were both in civil service?
Yes, sir.
Your mother was in IAS?
So she is in the IAS.
She's in the IAS. And your father was in income tax?
Yes, sir.
Yeah. Is he retired or still?
He's retired.
He's retired. And you live in Chandigarh?
Yes, sir.
Now, most of the questioning will be based on your death, right?
Yes, sir.
And that is how we have tried to formulate our questions on a wide range of...
Yes, sir.
Foreign services, yours, therefore, a number of questions.
Yes, sir.
Current affairs.
So, what is the Westphalian Treaty?
This ended the 30-year war and established the principle of nation-states.
In the 1800s?
No, no. 17th century.
17th.
Read it, it's a very,
yes,
important
thing. Yes, I read it.
Was it Metternich, no? The Austrian diplomat, he was the Sprigman. Read it. Okay, so questions we feel would be based on your biodata.
Yes, sir.
and you have, and therefore we have asked you, like, go to a court.
Yes, sir.
Udan, CAA, Air India, US President's visit, what are the issues involved?
Yes, sir.
Then, which country poses the biggest security threat? You've said rightly, China.
Yes, sir.
And then, the biggest security internal threat? Terrorism is?
Yes, sir.
Is there any other threat you see to our security? Yeah, internal threat?
Sir, I was trying to think of something, but terrorism
Nexalism?
Was the
Nexalism?
First.
Nexalism?
Yes, sir.
Nexalism? No?
Yes, sir, but is it such a big issue? I mean, it is being contained.
It's a continuum. No, it's not contained.
Yes,
see
sir.
How many deaths are still occurring?
Yes, sir.
What is the biggest headline story? It's not that India is doing it, but coronavirus itself is the biggest story, right?
Yes, sir.
How many cities has China locked down? Any idea?
No, sir.
How many people have been locked down? 50 million? Okay. So, by and large, you gave good answers, but these are the areas where we feel Foreign Service, then some important judgments of the Supreme Court.
Yes, sir.
Then there could be some important issues like flagship programs of the government. For instance, Make in India, how it is doing, ease of doing business, you know?
Yes, sir.
So these are the areas we should. And then lastly, on your hobbies also,
yes,
you've been asked questions. Those are also areas. Are you reading newspapers?
Yes, sir.
Read carefully.
Yes, sir.
When you read a newspaper, read it twice, something important. Read it twice so that you don't have to. Then go back to that, it will remain in your memory.
Yes, sir, I think I'm struggling with retention.
The only way is to read it once or twice or thrice,
yes,
if you
sir.
Can't. And take out the cuttings every day, whatever is important. Take out the cuttings, make a folder, read it again and again. At least devote 1 hour every day to reading whatever you have read before. It will remain in your memory. Now, you look at the important events which have been taking place.
Yes,
coronavirus is there. There is an agitation on CA. You were asked a question on European Parliament, why it has deferred a resolution on CA. Because there is going to be India-EU
yes.
summit.
Yes,
but they have not given up that. Then important things like Time magazine has brought out a very scathing article, critical
yes.
article on Mr. Modi. Those are the things which are happening.
Yes, sir.
Economist has brought out, Time magazine have called him probably divider in chief or something.
Yes, sir.
So these are the things which on which you have to work hard, right?
Yes, sir.
Bas ye padhti rahiye and come back again after 15 days if you. When is your interview?
Sir, 17th.
Oh, 17th. Very close. All right.
Okay.
So good luck. Which newspapers are you reading?
Sir, the Hindu and Indian Express.
Hindu and Indian Express.
Yes, I've been told to read the Times of India from now on.
Times of India is excellent.
Yes.
It's excellent, carries a lot of information. And Hindu is good for art editorials.
Yes, sir.
It gives you an analysis, which is excellent. If you like, you can give up Indian Express, but if you have time, there's no harm. But
yes, sir.
These are the two goodies. Balance papers.
Yes,
right.
Thank you so much. Don't forget to like, share and subscribe to our channel and press the bell icon to never miss an update.